Hi everyone, welcome to another amazing WordPress Wednesday. I'm Corey Ashton here at WebTegrity, and I wanted to talk today about child themes. And I know that we've talked about it a little bit in the past, but today I want to walk you through how to use a plugin to make a child theme and make some changes more or less permanent on your website. First of all, I want to definitely thank our sponsors. Our partner is WP Engine. It runs amazing WordPress hosting. So if you have a WordPress website, look into their hosting. It's fast, secure, and incredible support for WordPress. Phenomenal team over there. WP Elevation, if you are an entrepreneur in WordPress, you need to check out their system. Fantastic. And WP 101 goes even deeper into amazing WordPress videos, teaching you advanced stuff even, because they even have more advanced videos. So check them out. Totally worth the money to spend there to become a lifetime member of their library. Amazing stuff. All right, you guys, let's get into it. Child themes. Y'all make fun of me because of my Texas accent, calling them child themes. We're going to talk about child themes. So if we go into our editor area, let's say that we wanted to, a couple of weeks ago, we were talking about changing the message on our 404 page, right? So whenever you go to your website, let's say wpwd.com, and let's say if I slide this down a little bit, I want you to take a look at the URL path here. So if I'm on here and I go and accidentally type in something wonky weird, you should get a 404 page, right? I'm gonna put the link to the video to explain 404s a little bit more. I'll put that down below in the description box. So if you haven't seen that video yet, I want you to stop for a second, pause this, click that link, go watch that video, because this is going to explain a little bit further into why I'm even doing this video on how to make a child theme. So let's say, move myself out of the way for a second, we want to change that 404 page permanently, right? Whatever message we decided to put on there in that last video, we want to make that effect take place no matter what happens whenever we update our WordPress website. So in order to do that, there are two ways to make that happen. You can either use a plugin to make a child theme, way to go on plugins, or even better yet, you can do it from scratch, because a child theme actually isn't that difficult to create. So today, for this WordPress Wednesday, I'm gonna walk you through how to do it with a plugin. But next week, we're gonna have our lead developer step in and be a guest here on WordPress Wednesday, and he's gonna walk you through how to create one from scratch. It's really super simple, and it's much, much better than using a plugin, because you don't necessarily need to bring in another plugin just to make something that simple happen. But for the time being, and if you don't have a whole lot of plugins happening on your website, I say go ahead and use a plugin. So we are going ahead and we've installed a plugin for creating child themes called Child Theme Configurator, okay? And whenever you do install it and activate it, it hides underneath your tool's child themes. So I have not really configured this yet, or generated it yet, so I wanted to walk you through that process. It's going to ask you, what is your parent theme? Sparkling is the name of the free theme that we use here for wpwd.com. And now it's going to ask you, what do you want to name your child theme? By default, it goes ahead and puts this in for you. That's totally fine, as long as you recall the fact that it's Sparkling Child. This is the name of your new theme that you're going to be using now, and it's going to be referencing Sparkling. That's all this means. This child theme is referencing all the content inside of the parent theme, Sparkling. So it's going to ask, you know, do you want to do all this fun stuff? I say leave the default settings here. That's totally fine. This is going to say copy parent theme menus, widget bar, and other options. Note this will override any child theme options you may have already set. Well, we haven't set any, so we can go ahead and do that. And then parse additional style sheets. So this says, basically, you can read these details. It's so funny whenever I'm dealing with people, they're like, well, what does this do? Most amazing authors will give you a little bit of a description, so just pause for a second and actually read what it says. It does say that this will basically add a lot of load time. So you'd only want to check the things that you would actually be making any edits to. And we're not going to be making any edits to them. So I'm just going to leave the default checked and go ahead and generate the child theme file. So it's going to take a few seconds. Now that it's done, fantastic. Finish, simple, just like that. What we want to go do here is check out the themes area now. So now we've got this child theme sitting here. Well, we actually want to activate that one. That's the one we want to be functioning off of from now on. So whenever we go to the front side of our website now and look at it, it should still be working properly, right? Everything works here. It sits the same, looks the same. Very, very good. All right. What we want to do, though, inside of this area now is be able to make any changes that we want to. Note, that, let me slide off the screen here so you can pay attention to what I'm doing. This is the file that it created for me, okay? Note over here on the side that it's pulling from Sparkling Child. If I were to go to Sparkling, if you've ever clicked Appearance and gone to Editor, you normally see all these PHP files happening over here, right? So I'm gonna select and switch back over to the parent. Look at all these files happening right here. Wow, it's a crazy amount of files happening. But whenever we're looking at just our child theme, select, here's now our CSS area. We can write any CSS we want. Anything you ever want to overwrite, you can drop right here and it'll overwrite anything inside of the parent theme, right? So that anytime you have to update the parent theme, no problem. You've got all this content sitting here that will always perfectly overwrite that. And you can constantly keep that one up to date without any sort of conflict or loss of configuration, right? That's what a child theme is all about. So, if I wanted to go in specifically and make a change to my 404 file, if I go back to Tools, go to Child Theme, Query Selector Rule, Import, all these good things here, Child CSS, what? Parent CSS, there's the example of all that parent stuff going on. Here are my files. Now, check this out. I want to change my 404 file. Copy selected to Child Theme, right? Normally, let me get back in focus here for a second. Normally, you would have to do all this via FTP. And for those of us that are a little bit more leery about jumping into your hosting account and drilling down into all the folders to try to find the right folder to get into and make changes inside of your specific theme, that can be a little bit daunting, a little bit overwhelming, and you don't always want to have to do that. So what you can do is use this plugin and it'll create that for you. So now, when I go back to Appearance and go to Editor, I should have, on the right side over here, check this out, now I've got a 404 template. So I can come in here, make any changes I want. So if I go back here and to my front, and let's go find that whoopsie woo file again. Whoops, that page can't be found, right? All right, I want to overwrite this and make this have something else. Let's say instead of whoops, it says, howdy. That's not only a Texas thing, but that's also a WordPress thing. Howdy. We're sorry. That page can't be found, right? So now I'm going to update the file. When I come back to the front side of my website and click refresh, you will break everything. That's not good. Don't break anything. It's this, you can't have that right there. So it's got to be this little bit of character, because any apostrophe inside there would actually break your whole website. That's true, because we're inside of PHP. Let me go back here for you and try that one more time. See, even people like me, whoopsie woo, make little mistakes. That's okay. There we go. Howdy. We're sorry. That page can't be found. All right. So adding in this little apostrophe right there inside of any sort of PHP would actually, this is a PHP call right here. So that would actually kill that statement. Whoops. So you want to add in a little bit of nerd code in there to make that apostrophe actually happen. Anyway, all that said to say, that's how simple it can be to actually create a child theme using this incredible plugin. You can copy any file, any PHP file that you want to make changes to. So if you want to widgetize something up in your header area that's not actually a widgetized area, you can copy, you can go to your tools, and you can go to your child themes area. You can go to your files area, come back on here, and you can go choose your header file and say copy that. Instantly, it will go ahead and create the file for you. It'll go to your parent theme, it'll copy the entire file, set it here for you to come in here to your right sidebar underneath your child theme appearance editor inside of your child theme, make any changes you want, and now you're running perfectly off of your child theme. Brilliant, right? Think about the possibilities on this. You could really completely dynamically change anything that any author's ever coded inside of their existing theme. All you have to do is be sure that you're not too afraid of PHP, that if you break things like that, whoops, okay. Always, always, always have a backup of what you're working on before you ever go into anything like this, right? That's what we preach here, is back it up. So be sure that you have a great plugin installed like Updraft Plus to do a backup, or if you're running on WP Engine, of course, you're probably going to be doing this inside of your staging site, which is amazing. WP Engine has this capability of giving you a playground, basically, an identical example of your existing website. You can go into and tinker all you want. Click the update, no big deal. If you break anything, it's no problem. All you have to do is one click and it'll pull down your live website again and bring it over here and let you play with it without your live website ever missing a beat. It's always active, always there for your visitors. It's a crazy cool environment. That's another reason why they're our choice for hosting. So if you have any questions on child theme stuff, please shoot us an email, give us a tweet. I'll put that information down below in the description box. But another thing you can do is stay tuned for next WordPress Wednesday, whenever Jason's going to step in and teach you how to code one of these child themes from scratch. All right, hope y'all have a great one. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.